I guess I learned it from my parents, that true love starts with friendship. A kiss on the forehead, a date night, fake an apology after a fight. I need a man who's patient and kind, gets out of the car and holds the door. I want a slow dance in the living room like we're 18 at sea. My father loves my mom. I want a road trip in the summers. I want to make fun of each other. I want to rock out to Billy Joel and flip our kids off when they call us old. He'll accidentally burn our dinner and let me be the Scrabble winner.
Hoping I would find your love along the broken road, but I got lost a time or two. Wiped my brow and kept pushing through. I couldn't see how every sign pointed straight to you.
Anomaly. Zach and Haylie, they are excited and grateful to share their special day with you. Family and friends, it's with great affection for Zach Miller and Haylie Schrader that we have gathered together to witness and bless their marriage in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Who gives this woman to be married to this man? Let's pray. Father, thank you for bringing us here today to witness the marriage between Zach and Haylie. May you be honored and glorified. May you work powerfully in our midst to show us your goodness and the brilliance of your creative power. May you unite Zach and Haylie together in marriage. And will you use today to remind many here of the love and affection that they had for their spouse on their wedding day. Lord Jesus, we love you, and will you bless our time together today. In Jesus' name. Amen. Haylie, you look absolutely beautiful. Zach, you look rather dapper yourself. Love for Zach and Haylie began a couple years ago. Zach, it was your patience and your respectfulness for Haylie that really captured her heart. Haylie, it was your tenacity that caught Zach's attention, but it's your care for him that he really loves. Zach and Haylie, years from now, you can tell people that your love for each other began in 2020. Who would have thought that something so good could have come out of such a difficult time? But God knew what he was doing. Today, we celebrate the love between Zach and Haylie. I'm honored to be here with you two on your special day. The idea that a marriage is a covenant between a man and a woman is God's brilliant idea. This is what Genesis 2 says. But for the man, no helper was found corresponding to him. So the Lord God caused a deep sleep to come over the man, and he slept. God took one of his ribs and closed the flesh at that place. The Lord God made the rib that he had taken from a man and into a woman, and he brought her to the man. And the man said, "This one at last is bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. This one will be called woman, for she was taken from man. This is why a man leaves his father and mother and bonds with his wife, and they become one flesh. Both the man and the woman were naked and yet felt no shame." God created the adventure we call marriage. It's God's design for a man and a woman to leave their families and create something new. God's design for marriage is for oneness and for trust. You and I can't even dream of designing something as beautiful and as brilliant as marriage. This is what the Bible says in Ephesians 5. It says, "Submitting to one another in fear of Christ. Wives, submit to your husbands as to the Lord. Because the husband is head of the wife as Christ is head of the church. He is the savior of the body. Now, as the church submits to Christ, so also wives are to submit to their husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives just as Christ loved the church and gave himself for her, to make her holy, cleansing her with the washing of the water by the word. He did this to present the church to himself in splendor, without spot or wrinkle or anything like that, but holy and blameless in the same way. Husbands are to love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. For no one ever hates his own flesh, but provides and cares for it just as Christ did for the church, since we are members of his body. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. To sum it up, each one of you is to love his wife as himself, and the wife is to respect her husband. Submit to one another as an act of worship to Jesus. When you want to be right, submit. When the conversation isn't flowing like it used to, when your moods are opposite, you know what I'm talking about, where you're excited and she's not, or she's loopy and you're not. When those cute little annoying habits aren't cute anymore. Husbands, love your wife. Pursue her heart. Keep paying attention to the details. Keep listening. Keep spending quality time with her. Continually show her that you are thinking about her throughout the day. Keep being patient with her. Wives, respect your husband. Keep seeking to honor him. When you're tempted to call your parents for help, ask your husband first. Laugh at his jokes. Tell him how big his biceps are. Go with him when he wants to go on adventures. One of my all-time favorite movies is Remember the Titans. And there's a pivotal moment in the movie where Coach Yost brings his defense in, and he starts to yell at them. And he gives them this crucial middle-of-the-game speech. And he says this, "I don't want them to gain another yard." And then the famous line is, "You blitz all night. Make sure that they never forget this night, that they always remember the Titans." As a coach, he's instilling confidence in them so that they can win. I remember the conversation that you and I had about, it's not about winning, really. It's that we just don't like to lose, Zach. So here's my middle-of-the-game speech for you and for everybody else here, because I hate losing. And you both know that I want you guys to have a lifelong healthy marriage. So this is what you need to do to have a lifelong healthy marriage. Remind yourself daily of the love of Christ. It's not the pursuit of a dream. It's not having everything in order. It's not even having similar hobbies. But instead, remind yourself daily that Jesus, the King of the universe, the one who created everything, loves you. He loved you so much that he gave his son to die for you. And then 3 days later, he rose again. That so that whenever you and I put our faith in him and trust in him, that we rise from death to life. When you remind yourself of this love of Christ, you remember that you're alive because he died. And you have life not because you deserve it, but because he gave it to you. This is a gift, and it's a gift of grace, and it's a gift of grace that produces an enormous amount of humility. A humility is the posture in which you need to engage every single day of your marriage. And it's this enormous amount of humility fueled by the love of Christ that is needed to submit to one another and to love each other as Jesus loved you. Zach and Haylie, as you prepare to pledge yourself to one another, let me charge you both to remember that your future happiness is to be found in a mutual submission and love for the other. Zach, it's your duty to love Haylie as yourself, to moment by moment lay down your life for her, to put her goals and interests above your own, to daily earn her trust, to protect her from every danger, to provide tender, humble, yet courageous leadership for her, to love her as Jesus loved you. Haylie, it is your duty to treat Zach with respect, to support and honor him, to create a healthy and happy home, to fear the Lord and intentionally follow Zach's leadership with wisdom and poise, to love him as Jesus loved you. It is the duty of each of you to find joy in the company of each other, to remember that in both interest and affliction, and affection, you are to be one and undivided. So now as you pledge to each other, it will require of you to give of yourselves fully. This is where you get to say, "I do." Zach, will you take Haylie to be your wedded wife, to live together in the covenant of faith, hope, and love according to the intention of God for your lives together in Jesus Christ? Will you listen to her inmost thoughts? Will you be considerate and tender in your care of her and stand by her faithfully in sickness and in health? and choosing her above all others as long as you both shall live. If this is the desire of your heart, will you say, I do?
I do.
Haylie, will you take Zac to be your wedded husband? To live together in the covenant of faith, hope, and love according to the intention of God for your lives together in Christ Jesus. Will you listen to his inmost thoughts? Be considerate and tender in your care for him as you stand by him faithfully in sickness and in health, and choosing him above all others as long as you both shall live. If this is the desire of your heart, will you say, I do?
Yep, I do.
Based on upon the pledges you have made to one another, would you continue to face each other as you share your vows with one another? Zac and Haylie have written their own vows, and they will share them with each other now.
Haylie, I can't promise every day will be perfect. I can promise my everlasting devotion and my unconditional love for a lifetime. I can promise to do my best to make you happy and to feel loved. I'll pray with you, dream with you, and build with you. I'll always cheer you on, be your protector, friend, and family. I promise.
Is it my turn?
Yep.
Okay. All right, this is literally how it starts. Everyone here knows I am no good at this mushy-gushy gross stuff, so bear with me. It's crazy to think back to now how we first met in first grade, going all the way through high school together, not knowing it one day we would be standing here about to be married. Me, the little shy girl marrying the cute, popular football guy. I mean, I'm a hot mess, but so I get the better deal here. But for real, you have changed my life so much more than you know, have shown me that there are good days, good guys still out there, and that no matter how bad things get, you will always be there to bring me out of my little isolated hole. So I promise to love you always. I promise to put the toilet seat down when you forget. I promise to try to hold your hand in public, keyword on try. And I promise to love you no matter what, even during the off season. All right, I'm done.
I'm done.
That was good. Can we please have the rings?
I'm going to need that one back now. I got you a little something new.
Oh, goodness.
A little new and improved.
Oh, goodness.
The rings are symbolic of your relationship. Just as the metal of the rings is pure, so shall your love be for each other. The circular nature of the rings represents the unbroken, continual nature of your commitment and marriage. Zac, as a symbol of your commitment, please place the ring on Haley's left hand and repeat after me. Haylie, I give you this ring.
Haylie, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
Promise.
Promise.
And devotion.
And devotion. Wow, that's weird.
Haylie, as a symbol of your commitment, please place the ring on Zac's left hand and repeat after me. Zac, I give you this ring.
Zac, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
Promise.
Promise.
And devotion.
And devotion.
Today, Zac and Haylie have chosen to braid three strands of a cord together into a single cord. The idea of this cord of three strands comes from God's word in Ecclesiastes chapter 4. It says this, it says, a person standing alone can be attacked and defeated, but two can stand back to back and conquer. Three are even better, for a cord of three strands is not easily broken. The braiding of three strands demonstrates how Zac and Haylie desire for God to be interwoven into every aspect of their marriage.
There must be a God, I believe it's true, 'cause I can see his love when I look at you. And he must have a plan for this crazy life, because he brought you here and placed you by my side. And I have never been so sure of anything before like I am in this moment here with you. Now for better or for worse, so much more
will be the proof that I mean what I say when I say I do. Yeah, I mean what I say when I say I do. These hands you hold will always hold you up when the strength you have just ain't strong enough. And what tomorrow brings, only time will tell. But I will stand by you in sickness and in health.
Let's pray. Father, we are so grateful for the deep and unwavering love you have for Zach and Haylie. Will you, with your sovereign and eternal power, reign and lead them throughout their marriage? Will you be the binding force between their marriage, and will you sustain them through the valleys and the mountains of their life? May they always turn to you for guidance, strength, and direction. May you daily remind them of your unconditional love for them. I ask this in the name of the Lord Jesus. Amen. As much as Zach and Haylie have declared their love for each other and made their commitment to each other in the sight of God and these witnesses, it is my pleasure to pronounce them husband and wife. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Zach, you may kiss your bride. You did it. Please stand and join me in celebrating for the very first time in the history of the universe, Mr. and Mrs. Zach Miller.